won't give you any money if that is what you seek.
Money? You offend me. I am an artist. Grubby coin does not sustain me. Poetry is my bread and mead.
Then I trust this doesn't have to get bloody.
Bloody? Pitiful Judas, no. I will take my leave.
Good horse. Oh, it saw me now. Oh god, a pack of wolves, Jesus Christ. It's not impossible. Anyway, where was I? Guess I must have missed a turn. Man, I was enjoying the view. This is what you get for making me miss such a beautiful sunset. Yeah, it's nice. What is this dude doing? What the hell was that? Oh, Jesus Christ. And as for you, the last two, I'll deal with you quick so I can finish enjoying my sunset. Oh, there's so many more. Jeez. Okay, looks like we're not going to be able to enjoy a sunset this go around, Phantom. Follow my lead. poked me. Poked me real good. Ah, Christ. Ooh, that hurt. There's usually not this many on the roads. So I'm just trying to get to my objective. Yeah. Now, is there more of you? Of course there's more of you. There's always more. Still more. What's happening? I don't like this. Too dark, way too quickly. I have a bad feeling about this forest phantom. Well, what better to do when you get a bad feeling than go exploring? Spotting me. Just snick, I think. Oh, boar. Lots of boar. Looks like. Maybe more boar than I was ready for. Get him, Dwarfka. I still have a very bad feeling about this forest. Oh well. Perhaps those thoughts will come to fruition at a later date. It's something. It got way too foggy and way too dark way too quickly for me to be comfortable with this area. Yeah, see? It's weird how quickly that fog cleared up once I got out of the forest. There's like a spear in there or something. Calm down.
Now you pay for your sins.
Oh, bandits. Wonderful. Come on. Put my cloak back on. Saxon guards. Ignore them for now. Didn't want to get spotted. Let's make that quick. It is. Can I meditate in distrust areas? I can. I'm gonna get up to the roof and do that. They did do a really good job. It's very pretty. I can go to Vinland a little later. There's not much for me there, but I can go there a little later if you want me to. It's like an old Roman city, I see. Really nice looking though. I believe so. Obviously some of these structures are new, but I think this is all ancient Roman architecture. That's very Roman, right? At any rate, those are Roman statues for sure.
Dane in our midst.
I'm looking for Pearson, the alderman of the Shire.
Our lord is not at home, but his wife is receiving visitors upstairs in her usual fashion. If you speak with her, pass on that we've run out of ale.
I swear to God, it's a worthy woman, you coxcomb. She's an excellent cook.
With a fine nose for truffles.
If Pearson does not return soon, wine will not be the only thing spilled upon his floors. Now, gentlemen, everyone is fractious with this waiting. Let us be civil at least.
Wilson's things just disrespect you, lady.
will come at one cry from me.
Sheathe your blade, lady. I'm Eivor of the Raven Clan, here at your husband's request.
Another day. I am Estrid, wife of the Lord of Essex. As you may have heard, my lord is not at home.
You don't speak as one from here. Where's your home?
These rain-sodden bogs and fog-washed hills are not my home, thank Christ. I come from Francia.
My grandfather walked on Frankish sod. He spoke of an appetite for conquest that rivaled our own.
Sadly, my conquests are reduced to pettish thanes and graceless men. All Frankish fire extinguished.
I'm wary of rounding up Saxons. Is your husband stolen, drunk, or wounded?
He'll be stalking the woodlands today, hunting game and ignoring the vital affairs of Essex. One such affair is why we called for you.
If I can find him, I'll remind him of his duties.
Ah, such would be a miracle. His favorite haunt is southwest of here. The lavender fields there attract the prey, God help him.
With luck, he hasn't been eaten, but I'll return either way.
Abbreviary of a broken heart.
Patience is a godly virtue, Adred.
Even the saints will tire of waiting for Pierce Stan to hang up his bow.
Sorry, I found a bit of noise.
With or without him.
Where am I going? Coast of England, I believe.
It seems Alderman Beerstan has made this ruin his longhouse.
This little stream is beautiful. Hold on, I gotta stop at this for a moment. Jesus. Wow. That just looks real nice. It do be looking good. It do be looking good. If you would like to like me to use any other weapons, I'm more than willing to try them out. I'm fine with swapping over to different weaponry or armor or what have you. Figured that would go. Try that again, dumbass. Try that again. Oh. He actually did try that again. Best I got is this, which is a two-handed sword. But, I can use it with one hand, like I do my big ol' axe. And the question is, what do I have in my offhand? What do you want me to use, Phantom? What do you want me to use? I do now, as a matter of fact. Would you like me to use two big axes? Use both, alright. My mask reappeared! I have my mask on again, yay! Alright. Righty or lefty? Let's see. I'll do it like this for a little while. Someone else has appeared to join the stream. Welcome, whoever you may be. Ah. Perfect. I killed him with my parry. All right. Make you happy, Phantom? I'm glad to hear it. After this quest up here, I'm probably going to be stopping the stream, though. I'm getting a little tired.
Hunting is a fine sport. I hope the Alderman has not become the prey. No good comes from a camp this bloody. They were caught off guard as they supped.
He's looking pretty alive. Logan. Alright, I unmuted Logan. I mean, yeah, he can if you want. Go for it.
Remains of the hunting party. This one was savaged by a large animal.
That doesn't bode well. That. That is a leg. Yeah. Yep, that. That is a leg. Neat.
Tracks in the grass.
It's gonna be a bear, isn't it? I'm gonna have to fight a bear. I kinda don't want to.
Lunan, guide me.
Hunting dog, perhaps? Is that what that was? That's a wolf.
They were attacked by a beast. Something strong enough to kill the horse. The hunters were prey to a large beast or two. I can only hope that Viestan still lives. Survey the area, Thulin.
Dead ahead? Yep. Oh, multiple bears.
Or accept your fate as a feast for bears. This is one Saxon you won't kill today. Gets the blood coursing.
Yes, I did just deal a shit ton of damage to that bear by drop kicking it. Freaking straight up knocked that thing out.
You have my gratitude to stumble upon me in my moment of greatest peril. Perhaps you were God sent.
This dude looks considerably older than his wife.
The thanes of Essex both want your balls and a blacksmith's anvil.
When do they not? You could return and report that the savage claw took me. Poor Beerstan, his exit pursued by a bear.
Which kind of makes me think it's not consensual.
No doubt my
just a theory.
Prefer his velvet paws to my callous hands. So, who are you? A sellsword?
Yeah.
You speak ill of your wife. Has your love faded, or were you ill-matched?
As family, we are as close as Cain and Abel. She is a willful woman, and I am a bad husband. You know me, it seems.
Only by reputation.
A deliciously teasing sentiment.
I am Abel of the Raven Clan.
I kind of like this dude.
You hinted at an alliance for the loan of my unique talents.
S'blood, yes. Let us return to Colchester at once, and we'll speak more of the delicate matter on my mind. I'm glad you...
Well, now that my mask is working again, I can actually equip the armor that I was rocking.
Yeah, is it downstairs?
Yeah, he doesn't seem...
I think he might be downstairs.
He doesn't seem like a necessarily bad guy so far, though. I guess we will await to see.
Lost many men on this hunt.
That's not my horse.
They will have the proper rights and their families will be cared for.
Your people sacrificed much for your sport.
They did. There is no balm for my tortured heart.
Why did you ask me here?
Do you believe in true luck? A Vavor?
I have loved.
But have you truly? Has a longing,
burned in your breast, a sweet lingering pain, paralyzing you with its sting.
There's pain enough in battle, but not seek it out in love.
I long for it, the thrill of a fight softly won. My wife Estrid lacks fire. She is a fish out of water, cold, dead.
She showed great passion when I met her, keeping her thanes in check.
Oh, they love her, it is true. Some with too much devotion. And I have not been a good and attentive husband. I have always been a plucked goose in matters of love, and a piss-poor ruler to boot.
Strong must be the hand that steers the ship, Biston.
My hand would rather tug the catgut of a well-crafted bow, my eyes narrowing at the sight of prey.
Aye, a crown sits heavy on the head.
Then let us run wild and free in the woods as the wolves do. Live on our wits, prowl, stalk, and feast.
You have a romantic way about you, Biston.
Do not fret. My guards will not worry you when we are together.
You mismark me if you think I'm capable of worry. Have you built your city in the ruins of an...
I honestly don't know. He seems fairly level-headed. Which I guess is good. He definitely shows humility. He probably wouldn't make for as bad as a ruler as he's saying.
Creative minds, coin, imagination, talent.
And your people. Is Essex happy?
That is a question I never really pondered. I suppose they are. I hope they are. Alfred believes I rule like a chickless hen, flapping and squawking over nothing but the farmer's dinner.
He interferes.
No, he disapproves. Is that not infinitely worse? We are nearing my hall. Your favor to Essex, Abel.
It may be I can speed your business along.
You'd think for a nobleman who loves to hunt, he'd have a nicer looking bow than the one he does. I found nicer looking bows in random chests.
You if I can.
Who is this owl, Bearston, that twitters in your ear?
An advisor, nothing more. Here to help Essex navigate her brewing storms. Now, my dear brethren, Adred, perhaps you will start us off. What troubles you?
You're a disgrace, Bearston. Couldn't get a sow pissed in an alehouse. Alfred's men are crawling all over Essex.
King Alfred, yes. Though it is within his right, the constant presence of his men is certainly an issue.
Someone.
Yeah. The month for coldest, the mistletoe is full grown, cloaked in her winter strength.
Meaning that we should weather this, stay strong? Yes, that's it. Not bend in the wind like stalks of wheat. And you,
I'm just going to make this really difficult for him.
Your preparations for the Lammas Festival. How can you think of spending so much coin when your people are starving?
Wine and song is the answer to any problem.
He should put his own ham fist in his purse and contribute coin to the festival.
Yes. You worry about the cost of such a festival, one that thanks God for our great harvest. Contribute your own coin, then. And Aldrich, do you yap like a she-hound as Adred does?
You know my thoughts, Bearston. The fear.
I like his outfit. That's
Alfred
cool.
Alfred for his wars when our harvest suffers day by day.
Fields will mean nothing if your land is taken.
Beware of sleep in a witch's bosom. Nor let her limbs ensnare you, for she will not bring an early harvest.
I, bosom's that?
No. I'm afraid I don't know what that means.
Oh man, an error occurred in my application.
Have I not answered all your questions?
I thank you for your candor, Bearstand. You have put my mind somewhat at ease.
Aye. Indeed. Good. With that, we are concluded, my lord. Now, if you'll pardon me, I have much to discuss with my wife.
They seem to have walked away happy for some reason. Alright, whatever. Each to their own. I'm gonna try on a new cloak. Let's try this one. They do! And I don't entirely know why.
Arm hand is all you need, Bisden. Whether on your hunting bow or on your helm.
All this talk of hunting makes me long for the woods.
Your wife awaits, Bisden. Aren't you worried some other man will drench your sheet with sweat?
Ha! She does as she must. As do...
Be like that.
You have done the impossible, Dane. Returned my errant gander to his queen.
My pettish love, such a stormy countenance clouds the sun of my return.
Your thanes drank the ale the abbot gifted us, all of it.
Now that is a tragedy my heart will not easily overcome.
If he looked at me with the same affection he shows for hunting deer, our marriage might have survived.
Essex seems
Essex
odd.
Seems at odds with itself. Have you called me here to fix the many problems I've already seen today?
No, no. I would not inflict the infighting of my thanes upon you, Eivor. Our matters are more delicate.
And of a more personal bent, requiring a finesse and discretion that the Saxons often lack.
So, what do you need of me?
I have a feeling this is going to get interesting.
Our affairs are more of heart than of state, Eivor. What little passion there was between us faded into bickering long ago.
We would have our freedom, Eivor. I from my wife, and my wife from Essex.
I'm too sharp a weapon for so soft a task. Why not part and be done with it?
Oh, were I a Dane, and divorce as simple as a slit throat. But it's not so easy as that.
Does your God not allow husband and wife to part?
Our God? Our king. There is much standing in the way of a joyous uncoupling. Ours was an arranged marriage, a political need, and not easily broken.
Explain yourselves, clear and plain, and I will do it. The poetry here is mind-melting.
We had a plan, a simple plan. A woman lost and a woman found.
Some time ago, we paid a Dane to kidnap me and ferry me safely to Francia. As you can see, he did not deliver.
He was certainly thorough in other regards.
Some Norse can be quick to take coin and slow to earn it. If I give my word, it is not broken.
Could we try the kidnap again? Much of the planning is done. It would only take a more trustworthy overseer.
It should be a bold venture if we do. Loud and brash and seen by all.
During our Lammas festival, merry peasants and guards with wandering eyes.
Your return to Francia would need a swift ship, with a captain ready to leave England.
We could ask him.
I would have thought his steed and seamen spent.
Come find me in the market, Eivor. Our unwelcome guests require food and ale to soften their anger.
My wife is a gracious and attentive host, Eivor. The only thing that keeps my braying thanes at bay.
And the woman found?
A darling maybud, Alvedon, my childhood sweetheart. I left her 20 years ago in Malden to marry my prickled pear.
20 years? An ember so cold we reignited.
We can hope. You must fan the flame. Find her. Bring her to my lakeside cottage and light a bonfire there. I will know to come. I believe she lived in the last house in Molden. A small, sweet place where fond memories were made.
I will do as you both ask, and ask Freya for success in this love game.
Good luck in your endeavors, Eivor. I pray you find my Alvedon with a fair face and a yearning heart.
So, looks like I gotta get an old dude laid and a... you know, we'll see how it goes. It appears as though I have to get this old dude laid and his wife, soon-to-be ex-wife, out of the country. By faking a kidnapping of her. You know, believe it or not, it's not the first time I would have done this. Okay. I think that'll be it for tonight, Phantom. I'm a little too tired to... A little too tired to continue. So I'm gonna shut off the stream.